So this presentation will be about reachability analysis of pushdown systems. Reachability analysis is a fundamental issue in the context of system verification. It's the dual of invariance checking. Consider a system and assume that you want to check that starting from a set of initial configurations, all the behaviors of this system will stay in a set of states which are safe. In order to check this fact, one possibility is to start from the set of initial configurations and compute the set of reachable states, for instance, computing the set of immediate successors and then computing again the successors of those ones and keeping doing that, and at the end getting the set of all possible reachable states starting from the initial configurations. And once we have this, check whether this set is intersecting the set of bad states, which is the set of non-safe states. So our problem consists in checking whether this intersection is empty or not. So this schema corresponds to forward reachability analysis, and our original problem now can be phrased as checking the emptiness of the intersection of the set of bad states with the set of reachable states. Alternatively, we may consider solving this problem using a backward approach. So starting from the bad states, we can compute the predecessors of those states in one step, two steps, and so on, until getting the set of all predecessors of the bad states. Now, the question that we need to solve is whether this set intersects the set of initial states. Again, we have to solve an emptiness problem, which is now phrased as the emptiness of the intersection of the initial state with the set of all predecessors of the bad states. Therefore, our original problem can be solved either by a forward or backward reachability approach. And the main question now is how to compute post-star and pre-star images. This problem is solvable in the case of finite state systems, which means systems that have a finite set of configurations. However, this problem is non-trivial and in general undecidable beyond finite state systems. We are going to address actually this problem for a particular class of infinite state systems, which are pushdown systems. A pushdown system is a finite state machine supplied with an unbounded stack. So we have a machine with a finite number of control states, and each transition may perform an operation on the stack. The set of operations that we can do are either push from symbol A, which will add a symbol A on top of the stack, or pop A, which is going to erase a symbol from the top of the stack, or nope, which means that the transitions that we are performing has no effect on the stack. So let's see a small example. We consider a system with two states, 0 and 1, and when the machine is at state 0, she can push a symbol A and go back to the state 0. Now, at some point, she can move to the state 1, and then she can repetitively pop symbols from A staying in the state 1. A configuration of this machine is a pair of a control state plus the stack content. A computation is a sequence of configurations that correspond to the application of the transition of the machine. For instance, starting from the initial configuration 0 with an empty stack, we can apply the push operation. Let's call this transition tau1 and this one tau2, and say that now by applying tau1, we can move to the control state remains the same, but the stack now has changed and we will have A in the stack. again, we can apply Taiwan once more. We will get 0 and this time 2 A's on the stack. Now we can decide to apply the transition tau 3 and go to state 1. And here, since the operation is nope, the stack has not changed. Now we can apply tau 2. We stay in the same state, but we remove 1 A and then we apply tau 2 to reach the configuration Y with 1 with empty stack. So the observable sequence of states is 0 3 times followed by 1 precisely 3 times. So the set of all observable sequences is the set 0 n times followed by 1 n times for any natural number n. So this language is not regular, which means that it cannot be defined by a finite state automaton, but it's context-free. However, in what follows, we are not going to consider this aspect related to the set of observable sequences, but to the aspect related to the set of reachable configurations. Why we are interested in this? Because pushdown systems can be used as a natural model for a class of programs, namely the class of sequential programs with recursive procedure calls. Intuitively, if a procedure P calls another procedure Q, this will correspond to an operation push Q, which means that we want to put Q, which is the callee, on the top of the call stack. Now, when Q will return, this will correspond to a pop operation, and then the caller P is now on the top of the stack. So to verify this kind of programs, it's natural to use pushdown systems as formal models and then ask reachability questions to solve, to verify safety properties about them. So coming back to our problem, which can be either solved in a backward manner or a forward manner, the main problem, of course, is to construct these sets, pre-star and post-star, of some sets of configurations. Here, the main problem is that these sets can be infinite in general. As we have seen in the previous example, the size of the stack can be arbitrarily large and can reach any natural number n. Therefore, in order to solve such a problem, we need finite representations of infinite states of configurations. Moreover, we need to have procedures for computing post-star and pre-star images that are terminating. So let's address the issue of representing in a finite manner infinite sets of configurations of pushdown systems. For that, let's consider again our example. The stack content is a sequence of A's, so it's a word of the form A, etc. So therefore, the set of configurations is a set of words or a language. For instance, here it will be 0 with A star union 1 A star. So here the key observation is the following. Although the set of observable computation is a context-free language, as we have seen previously, the set of stack contents actually is a simple language and it's a regular language. So an important question is whether this is all the time the case. And the answer is yes. So indeed, the important fact about pushdown systems, which makes them easy to verify, is the following theorem. For every set of configuration C, which is regular, which means that this set is given by some finite state automaton, the sets pre-star of C, which means the set of all the predecessors of C, and post-star of C, which are the set of all successors of C, are also regular and constructible. A consequence of this important fact is that our problems can be solved using automata techniques. Indeed, given an automaton for pre-star of B, it's possible to construct an automaton for the intersection with init, because finite state automata are closed under intersection. And then it's possible to solve emptiness on this automaton. Similarly, this can be done for post-star. So this way, we have reduced the reachability problem in pushdown system to emptiness in finite state automata. So let's see concretely how these sets can be constructed. First, we need to define the representations that we need for infinite sets of configurations of pushdown systems. So let's consider a pushdown system P with control state P1 to Pn. We will associate with this pushdown system finite state automata that we are going to call P automata. And such an automaton A will have an initial state for every control state of the original pushdown automaton P. So this is a standard finite state automaton over the stack alphabet of P. This automaton represents the set of configurations which is given by, for every control state PI from 1 to N, the language recognized from initial state I. For instance, let's consider again our example and define the automaton, which has now two states, S0 and S1, which is given as follows. So this automaton recognizes the set of configurations 0 with the stack AA and the configuration 1 with the stack A. Now, having defined our representations, the P automata, let's see how do we compute the set of configurations that are successors of a given such an automaton. We have two cases to consider. First, the case of a push rule. So consider a rule of the form Si push gamma Sj. And we want to compute the successors by this rule of a set of configurations C that is given by some automaton, where we have the initial state Si and Sj, okay? And this represents our set C. In fact, the application of this is simply to add the transition gamma from Sj to Si. The reason is, if I have a configuration PiW in my original set C, then after adding this transition, so assume that we have here W, going to some accepting state. Now, after adding the gamma, we will have Pj gamma W in the set of successors. Now, the second case is a pop rule. So let's consider a rule of this form. And similarly, some initial set of configuration given by some automaton. Now, the intuition is that if from Si, there is a transition by gamma going somewhere, let's say to state Q, then we need to erase from any configuration that is accepted starting by gamma and going to some final state, we want to erase gamma, which means that we need to add an epsilon transition from Sj to the state Q. Epsilon is the empty word. So now, if Pi gamma W in is in our original set, then the configuration Pj W will be in the set of successors of this set. Notice here that since we are adding epsilon transitions in the automaton, so we have to be careful about when we say that there is a transition gamma from Sj to Q. Actually, this transition gamma can be of the form a sequence of epsilon transitions followed by a gamma. Finally, you may have noticed that here the state should be Pi and Pj, since we are talking about a transition rule in the pushdown system. So this is a mistake, and the same holds also for what I said in the previous slide. So as we have seen, the construction is actually very simple and is based on saturation of the original automaton, adding transitions until no new transitions are possible. The construction terminates because the number of states of the automaton is finite and fixed. It's possible to prove that this construction is correct, which means that it leads to an automaton which captures precisely the set of successors. The construction I have shown was for the successors. For the pre-star, it's just symmetrical. To conclude, we have seen a class of infinite state systems for which reachability problem is decidable, and this is based on the regularity of the set of reachable configurations. The construction we have seen can be used for solving other verification problems, like model checking for temporal logics. For more details and further developments about this topic, please look at the links given below.